By the end of this video, you will master these three pleated tools, such as the Pleats Tool, the Pleats Fold Tool, and the Pleats Sewing Tool in CLO 3D. We will also be creating multiple fabrics to making the pleated patterns, then improving the pleated quality and ready to make amazing garments just like these. An evening dress, backless with front pleated, a back pleated skirt with yoke, and more. Are you ready? Let's do it. So the rule of thumb, we need 3-to-1 fabric ratio to create pleats or gather, okay? So all we need to remember right here, right now, this concept. 3-to-1 fabric ratio to create pleats. And anytime you create odd segment, you will have these odd pleats. For example, you see right here? I create right here, 3 segments, and I copy it, turn into 3-to-1 ratio, and here the pleat came with 1.5. As you can see right here, this is the whole pleat and this is half of the pleat. Up here, I created even segments. So I create even segment, the pleat came out even. So as you can see right here, number 6 is I create 6 segments, 4 each are these 1-to-3 fabrics, okay? So 6 segments right here, 6 segments right here, and I merge them together. And over here, I created 7 segments right here, okay? So depend on your design, whichever segment you wanna choose or create, if it fit with your design, do so. No right or wrong, okay? So this is, I created 7 segments, it came out. So the total of the pleat is 3.5. Just remember this, 3-to-1 fabric ratio for creating a pleat. And if you created odd number, odd segment of numbers, you will get odd segment of pleat right here. And with this pleat, I use these 3 amazing pleats tool in CLO 3D, and we will use all those pleats tool for this tutorial, okay? Lastly, but it's awesome. So as you can see right here, these are the 2 pleated pattern as well as I created from the pleats tool right here. It's so cool, guys. You can create amazing garments out of this pleat tool just like this. I used the pleats tool to create this dress. See right here, this is the backless pleat dress, and right now is for sale on Etsy. How amazing! I'm here in CLO. First thing we need to do is create fabrics. Okay, we're going to create 8 fabrics. So to create fabric, I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and click on this rectangle tool. Click on it to select. If you can't find rectangle tool right there, it should be behind your polygon tool. Just click on that polygon tool and then select rectangle tool. After that, I'm going to click one on the page to bring this create rectangle window. And as I mentioned earlier, we need to create 8 fabrics. To do that, it's easy. Okay, we're going to type in the width 25. And you can create the width any number you want, but for this example, I'm going to type in the width of 25 cm, which is centimeter. Then the height, I'm going to press down the tab key and then type in the height 40 centimeter. Then come down here, replicate. I'm going to select the number of shape to 8 right there, okay? So as you can see the preview right here in this 2D workspace, we have 8 of these patterns. Okay, then I'm going to click on OK. Okay, so now we not only see 8 patterns over here, we also see 8 patterns over here in this 3D window. So I'm going to next to deselect these pattern pieces. To do that, I'm going to come over here to the Transform Pattern tool, click on it to select. And just let you know, any tool right here, when it's turned this blue color, it means that tool is active, okay? So I'm going to click one on that tool. Now it is active. I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. After that, we want to create internal line for these four pattern pieces. And to do that, I'm going to come over here to this Edit Pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to just my key select these four right there. And then just hover the mouse on top of that right there. And then right click. And I'm going to select Offset as Internal Line. This will bring this Offset as Internal Line window. And I'm going to type in the distance for 10 cm. And number offset, I wanted just one. As you can see right here, the preview appear. We have one internal line for each of these pattern pieces. Then I'm going to leave everything as is and select OK. Okay, so CLO tried to help us out. Now, these internal lines are selected by default, okay? So all we need to do is just hover the mouse over that yellow highlighted area, right click, and we are going to select cut, okay? So as you can see, we just cut these pattern pieces. After that, I'm going to delete these four pattern pieces that we don't need. To do that, I'm going to come over here to the Transform Pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to once again, guys, my key selects all that pattern pieces that we want to delete and press on the delete or backspace on the keyboard to delete. So as you can see, we have this now 25 by 10 and this right here 25 by 40 centimeters. Okay, so once again, guys, I'm going to my key selects all these four pattern pieces and bring it over here. Okay, next I'm going to come over here to this 3D toolbar and I'm going to select this reset all patterns icon right here to reset all the pattern to mirror the pattern in this 2D pattern. And I'm going to pan it over to right here a little bit. Okay, now we're going to arrange this pattern a little bit different, okay? So I'm going to my key select both of this pattern because I want to show you the effects that I mentioned earlier, okay? So I'm going to bring this up as well. Since we're going to create the pleat, I want all these patterns stacked on top of each other rather than side to side because when the pleat expands, we don't have to like, you know, rearrange it over and over. So now, once again, I want to come over here to this icon. This is important. Looks like a t-shirt icon. It's reset all pattern icon. Click on it. As you can see, now a pattern just mirror with this 2D pattern workspace, okay? Next, I'm going to label this pattern. To label the pattern, I'm going to come over here to this 2D window once again and select this annotation tool right here, letter A symbol, click on it. And then hover the mouse to the right, I'm going to select pattern annotation. Then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. And I'm going to click right onto that pattern and type in three, okay? Then I'm going to click on this pattern right here and I'm going to type in 6 and next I'm going to type in right here 7 and I want to adjust this number a little bit. They are not laying properly. So To mold that pattern, I'm going to come over here to this edit annotation tool, click on it. Then once again, guys, this tool is now active because it turned blue. By the way, guys, I have a tutorial on how to use annotation tool right below in this video. So I hope you guys find it useful, okay? And I'm going to just click on it and then drag just like that. So now we have a pattern label 3, 6, 7. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to create 3 segments, 6, I'm going to create 6 segments, and 7, I'm going to create 7 segments. And this pattern right here is going to be saved for the pleats tool itself, okay? It's so cool, guys. So first of all, let me freeze this top right here, because since Close 3D is, as you know, if you don't freeze certain patterns, it will fall on the ground, which we don't want. So to freeze this pattern, I'm going to come over here to the transform pattern tool, click on it. Then my key selects that one, press down shift, my key select the next one. Then while the shift key is still pressing down, continue selects all these top pieces, and then I'm going to release the shift key on the keyboard and then hover the mouse over that yellow highlighted area, right click, and I'm going to select freeze. Just come down here, far down here, and this freeze right here, click on it to select. So as you can see now, let me click one on the page first to deselect, okay? You see the differences of the color of the of the patterns. The blue now are freeze, and the one that white are not freeze. So next, we are going to sew the top part, because this pattern right here, we are going to sew it together, okay? And since it only have 1 segment to segment, it's easy to use the segment sewing tool. Click on it. You see the second sewing machine icon from the top, click on it and then hover the mouse to the right and select segment sewing. Then I'm going to click one right there to start, and then click one right here to sew to. And even though this highlight blue looking thing, it somehow, sometimes it looks like I'm sewing to the next one, but actually I don't. So don't worry, just come over here and click back on the transform pattern tool to get out that sewing tool. And as you can see in this 3D window, you see the sewing thread appear right here. That means these pattern pieces are sewn together, okay? Next, this is really cool, guys. So I'm going to split these into 3 segments. To do that, I'm going to come over here. Okay, we have 2 options here. You see this edit pattern tool right here. You can click on that tool and select edit pattern tool or add point slash split line tool, whichever you want. These 2 tools are work just fine to split the pattern pieces. So I'm going to select edit pattern tool, okay? Then I'm going to come back here. Then I'm going to just click one on that line that I'm going to split. And then while the mouse pointing over that line right there, I'm going to right click and select split. And there, the split line window pop up. I'm going to just scroll the mouse down here and select uniform split. And as I mentioned earlier, number of segments, we want 3. Okay, then I'm going to click on OK. So as you can see, we just split the into 3 segments. 1 segment, 2 segments, 3 segments, which means produce us 2 points. This first point and this second point. Okay, next, right here, we have number 6. So we are going to create 6 segments. Once again, while the edit pattern tool is active, just hover the mouse over there. Now click it. And as you can see, the line turned yellow. I'm going to, once again, that mouse still pointing on that yellow line, right click and select split right there. After that, with this split line window pop up, I'm going to come down here to uniform split, click on it. Then I'm going to just click and then drag to highlight that number, and I'm going to type in number 6. As you can see, number of segment 6, okay? Then I'm going to click on OK. Once again, guys, as you can see, we just create 6 segments, and that means we produce 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. So 5 points with 6 segments. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 segments. Okay. Next, up here, we are going to make 7 segments. Another thing I want to point out, guys. So, since we have the equal amount of fabric right here, the more segment we create, the smaller each segment becomes, okay? You will get a better idea after we produce the pleat here. So, next I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool once again. I somehow click it off, so be sure to be aware of what tool you're on, or CLO doesn't know and it doesn't work. So we have to be on either edit pattern tool or add point slash split line tool. Okay, so once again, I'm going to select edit pattern tool, click on it. Then just hover the mouse over it right here. We want to split to 7 segments. Then click on that line. Then right click and select split. After that, come down here to uniform split, then highlight that number and type in number 7, and I'm going to click on OK. So let me zoom in just a little bit right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 segments. Okay, next up, first of all, let me click one on the page to deselect, okay? So next step here, we're going to create the internal lines on to that pattern and on top each point, okay? So let me show you. However though, CLO invent this awesome tool that we can do. It look kind of daunting, but it's not really. So first of all, we need the internal polygon slash line tool to create the internal line. To get the internal polygon slash line tool, you can either come over here to this shape looking tool right here, which is internal polygon slash line tool, or press letter G. Click on it to select. Then I'm going to zoom in. Okay, the closer we zoom in, the easier and the more accurate that we can create this internal line onto this point, okay? So to do that, just hover the mouse over and you can see this guy pop up. Click one to start, and I'm going to press down shift just to be safe. And then I'm going to just click right there twice to end the internal line, okay? Next, I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to come back, and as you can see, it's highlighted in yellow, mean that line is selected. So I'm going to just place that mouse over that line, and I'm going to right click. I'm going to select copy. Then nothing really happened. However, we already copied this line, okay? We have to hover the mouse over that line once again, and then right click, and we're going to select paste. Okay, once again, now we have this line right here. We're not finished yet. So what we're gonna do, once again, I'm gonna zoom in close because I want to place that line right there on top of that point. And I'm going to right click once again. So this will bring this paste window, and it tells us the amount of interval, which is 3.59. That's a segment length that we have and the number of shapes. So as you can see, we need 1, 2, 3, 4 more lines. So we're going to just click on this arrow right here to increase to, once again, 4. Okay, and looks like I kind of mess up this part a little, but again, we can go back and rearrange it later. I'm going to click on OK. Okay, so I'm going to rearrange this internal line. I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. And as you can see, I place it kind of near to this point right here. So I'm going to try to click and then move it. Okay, looks like it's hard to do. Let me just my key selects all that line right there. And I'm going to press down the delete key on the keyboard to delete that line. This time I'm going to try something different. So once again, go to that internal polygon slash line tool or press letter G on the keyboard. And I'm going to just click one and then press down shift and click toward the end. Once again, you don't have to worry about the length of this internal line because we will use this awesome trick on CLO to extend the line to meet the end of the pattern edge, okay? So right now we're going to just create internal line once again, hold down shift, and then click it twice to end. So while the internal polygon slash line tool is active, I'm gonna just click one on that point, press down shift, and then click toy to end, or you can press enter. Let me show you that. So click one on the point, press down shift. Okay, then I'm going to click just one while hold down the shift, and then I'm going to press return and enter on the keyboard to confirm. And as you can see, we just create these internal lines for all the points right here. So next I'm going to do the same right here. Again, zoom in a little bit, press down shift, and then click toy to end, press down shift, click toy to end. I'm going to do the same down here, click one to start, press down shift, and then just come down here and then click toy to end. Okay, so this is awesome trick, guys. I'm going to switch back to this edit pattern tool, click on it. Then I'm going to extend this internal line to meet this edge of this pattern, okay? And we can do that all at once. Once again, just click one on the page to deselect. Then I'm going to marquee select that line right there. And I'm going to press down shift. Marquee selects all these lines. The same right here. Now all these lines are highlighted in yellow. I'm going to release the shift key on my keyboard. Then I'm going to hover the mouse over that highlighted area, right click, and I'm going to select extend slash trim, and then hover the mouse to the right to pattern outline. Ta-da! So as you can see, now all the internal line just reach to the edge of the pattern outline. Okay, that's what we want. Okay, so next we are going to, as I mentioned earlier, guys, we want this pleated fabric 3-to-1 of the fabric that we sew to create any pleats, any gathering, okay? So we have many options to do it. However, I'm going to show you one that I use all the time. And right here, I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and select the transform pattern tool, click on it to select once again, and I'm going to marquee select, and then press on shift, marquee select, and press on shift, marquee select. Now we all selected, right? So I'm going to right click and select copy once again. Then I'm going to Once again, right click and select paste. Then I'm going to right click and this bring this paste window, and I'm going to, you see number of shape, I'm going to select 2, 3. Oop, choose me, select 2, 2, because I already have one earlier, sorry. So we want total of this pleats pattern 3 to 1, okay? So next I'm going to click on okay to confirm. So after that, I'm going to merge these pattern pieces together. To merge the pattern pieces together, guys, you must be on this edit pattern tool or it doesn't work. Okay, so edit pattern tool, click on it. Then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. And I'm going to marquee select these two edges. And then you see these yellow highlighted appear. I'm going to just hover the mouse over that yellow highlighted and then right click and select merge. Just like that. I'm going to do the same right here. Once again, CLO try to help us by left all the pattern selected. We don't want that. We just want to click one on the page to marquee select, choose me to deselect. Then we're going to marquee select just the edge together. Then hover the mouse over that yellow line, right click and select merge. Okay, so as you can see, we just merged these pattern pieces to one. However, there's something we need to do before we complete. So if I click one on the page to deselect, and if I zoom in a little bit, you see right here, have the blue line rather than red line. Blue line is the guideline. Red line means the internal line. For the pleat to work, we need to create internal line. And to do that, once again, just use the polygon slash line tool. I'm going to press down letter G on the keyboard to get that tool. And then I'm going to click one right there to start. And I'm going to just hover down because it already have a guide and have a point, which is easy. We're not gonna mess it up. So I'm going to click on that point right there twice to place that internal line. I will do the same right here. Because we merged three patterns together, we will need two internal lines right there. Okay, so next we're going to come down here and repeat the step. Merge the pattern together and create internal lines for each pattern part that we merge, okay? Once again, I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool, then select this edit pattern, and then marquee select. You can marquee or click one right here and then press down shift on the keyboard to click another one, and then now I can hover the mouse over the highlighted area and then right click and select merge. I'm going to do the same right here. Click one right there and then press down shift and click on this edge of the pattern, right click and then merge. Okay, so next we are going to create the internal line for this right here and for this right here. Let's just click one on the page to deselect, then I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and select this internal polygon slash line tool to select. Then I'm going to click one to start and just hover the mouse down here and then click twice to end. I'm going to do the same right here and then come down here. Okay, it looks pretty good. So I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool once again, click on it, guide to select. Then I'm going to pan it down a little. We want to merge these pattern pieces together. Once again, click one, press down shift, click the next pattern, right click, and select merge. The same with here, click one to start, and then press down shift and click the next pattern. And then right click and then select merge. Okay, next I'm going to click one on the page to deselect, Then I'm going to press down letter G on the keyboard to get the internal polygon slash line tool and click 1 to start. Then click twice to end. Click 1 to start. Click twice to end. Okay, let me zoom back out and pan it down a little. So as you can see right here, we just create a pleated pattern. Next, we are going to use this pleat fold tool, guys. It's awesome. Okay, so this tool right here, okay, so come to this 2D toolbar, click on it, and you see right here, pleat fold tool, click on it. So this pleat fold tool, when we click one right here to start, and then click twice right here to end, after we click it twice, this pleat fold window pop up, and we have a choice. You can either select knife pleats or box pleats or accordion pleats. For this example, I'm going to select box pleats, okay? Then reverse direction, we don't want it. We want number of internal line per pleat 3 and fold angle 0 to 360, outside fold 0, inside fold 360. That's perfect. So to understand this, guys, if we don't use this pleat folding tool, we have to go in and try to fold, adjust this fold angle one by one, which is a pain in the rear. We don't want that. So this pleat tool allow us to click one, three clicks, okay? Then we create the perfect fold for a pleated. Next, I'm going to come down here, click on OK. Okay. Next, I'm going to repeat the step with this one. So I'm going to click one to start and then click twice to bring this pleat fold window. And I'm going to check on the box pleats again. And then number of internal line per pleat, 3, fold angle 0 to 360, outside fold 0, inside fold 360, then click on OK. Okay, so as you can see, the one that we did the pleats fold have different color compared to the one that we not yet do the pleats fold. So I'm going to repeat the step with this one as well. So click one to start and then click twice to end. Then these pleats fold window pop up. I'm going to click on that box pleats and number of internal line per pleat 3 and fold angle 0 to 360 and outside fold 0, inside fold 360. Then I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, that is so cool, guys. So next, I'm going to strengthen these pattern pieces, okay? So strengthen the pattern pieces will give us this pleat effect that we want, okay? You must strengthen these pattern pieces first. So it gives us less collision, plus it gives us this fold sharpness that we want to strengthen the pattern. Once again, I'm going to come over here to this. This tool is really useful, guys. This transform pattern tool, we always use that tool over and over. Click on that to select. Shortcut key for that is letter A. Or another tip that I want to point out here, if you press command or control plus letter A on your keyboard, you select all these pattern pieces. That's what we want. All I need to do now, just hover the mouse over that pattern, right click, and select strengthen right there. Perfect. So as you can see right now, all the pattern pieces turn yellow except the one that we freeze, but that's okay. Okay, so next I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Next, I'm going to sew these pleats pattern onto this pattern pieces. To do that, we are going to use this amazing tool right there in here. Just click on that Pleats Tool and then come to this Pleats Sewing Tool. Click on it. Okay, I'm going to start from the bottom first. So we are going to sew the single top piece first. Click one to start. Click once again to end that sewing. Then I'm going to click one with this pleat sewing pattern. And I'm going to just hover the mouse over to the right. And then click one to end the pleat sewing. So as you can see right here, now this pleat is sewing to this top part right there. The same as here. I'm going to repeat the step with this pattern here. So click one to start. Click once again to end. Click one to start. Hover the mouse over to the right. And then click once again to end. We just sew the part two. And right here, I'm going to once again click right here. Right here. Click right here to start. Hover the mouse over to the right. And then click once again to end. Okay, so next I'm going to switch my tool back to transform pattern tool. Then I'm going to press the space bar on the keyboard to simulate. That is really cool, guy. Okay, I just pressed on the space bar one again to stop the simulation. Okay. So next, I'm going to zoom in to this 3D window. And as you can see, a pleat don't look that good. That's okay. We can fix that. So there are something that we can fix these pleats, okay? Depend on how big the fabric that you are using. For this example, the fabric not so big. So I want to show you this. So with this skirt right here, all this skirt right here, I have the particle distance 2, 7, the same as here, to give this smooth look, as well as, let me get this bigger one, see right here, to give this smooth look. And I also have this thickness of rendering to 1.5. I also darken the yoke to make this split more pop. Okay, so this is better. You see right here, the pleat is really crisp and smooth. That's what we want. So it's depend on how big your computer is. The particle distance is slow down your computer if you like keep decreasing. I tried it fine and almost like really freeze my laptop. So I just started with 10, then it still doesn't look that crisp. So I decreased the particle distance to 7 and it looks all right. That's why I stopped at 7, because again, I work on my laptop. It could be really intense for the rendering process. However, this is also another important right here. You see this line right there? It's smooth. That because all this sewing line right here turn curve. Sometimes, even though we use this automatic, let me get back to a pleat right here. Even though we use this pleat sewing tool, sometimes it doesn't really give us all these line sewing turn to curve, but I will show you in a bit, okay? All right, so as you can see, we just finished sewing a pleat right here, right here, right here. Last but also important, okay, back to a pleats tool here. So we have these three tools right here, and that's so amazing. You can create any pleats. We can create accordion pleats. Let me go back to the garment that I showed you earlier. So the night pleats, the bug pleats, the accordion pleats. It's so cool. So let me come back here and I'm going to show you how to use the pleats tool for these pattern pieces. As you can see, we have this pleated pattern is equal to the first pattern that we have. I'm going to show you how to use the pleats tool to create the pleats for this pattern, okay? To do so, I'm going to come over here to this, to the toolbar, click on it and see this pleat tool right here. Click on that pleat tool. Then I'm going to click one right here. Then I'm going to press down shift because I want this straight line down. Then I'm going to click one to end. Then as you can see, this highlighted blue area, I'm going to click one to bring this pleat window. Then I'm going to select bark pleat. You can select any pleats you would like, but for this example, I'm going to select bark pleat. And number of pleats, I'm going to select 3. Then the depth, I'm going to select 3. After that, leave everything as is and click on OK. After that, I'm going to press down the spacebar on the keyboard to simulate. Okay. So let me zoom in just a little bit. So a pleat doesn't come out too well, but that's okay. So I'm going to come over here to this transform pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to select on that pattern, that pleated pattern, and I'm going to right click and I want to select reset 2D arrangement selected, okay? Then I'm going to just zoom out a little bit and I want to bring that pleat up a little bit. Now I'm going to press on the spacebar one again to simulate. Okay, so this is much better. So let me zoom in a little bit and I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And by default, a pattern piece is selected. I'm going to just click one on the pleated select. Okay, so we finished sewing all these pleats together, guys. We finished all the hard works. Now all we need to do is improve these pleats, okay? To improve these pleats are easy, guys. First of all, the particle distance are too big because by default, I set it to 20. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click on to the right side right here, click on this object browser to open the object browser. And I have to click one more time on this property editor to open that as well. Okay, so as you can see, a property editor is empty. That because we do not select any pattern pieces over here, so it doesn't know that we have any property at all. So if I click on the pattern pieces now, as you can see, the property editor show us what we have. First thing, particle distance is 20. We want to change all these particle distance to 5 because 5, that's a number I came up with. You can change to, you know, 7, whatever it is, but for now I'm going to change to 5. Is perfect. So I'm going to apply the particle distance to all these fabric pieces. To do that, I'm going to just command or control plus letter A to select all these pattern pieces. And I'm going to come over here to this property editor and just click and highlight it. And I'm going to type in number 5. And I'm going to press and return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, so now I'm going to click one on the workspace to deselect and I'm going to press on the spacebar to simulate. Ta-da! It looks better already, guy. Next, I'm going to add the fabric onto this pleated fabric. Let me zoom in just a little bit. And I'm going to press on the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. I also want to unstrengthen this pattern piece first. Again, command or control plus letter A, then right click and select unstrengthen. Then I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to simulate and press it one again to stop. Okay, so let's change the fabric. I'm going to change to wool fabric. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this library tab, click on it to open. then fabric, and I'm going to type in right here wool. Wool fabric is perfect for any pleated, any design that kind of give it a little bit of heavy butt. So let me select that wool cashmere, click on, and then drag and drop onto the fabric. And now a fabric, just change it to wool. Now I'm going to change the color. Just click on the fabric and I'm going to change the color to maybe a little. Okay, we have an issue here. All right, so as you can see, when I try to change the color on the fabric, it doesn't work. That's okay. To make the color see through, we have to come over here to this property editor and remove this texture, okay? So just hover the mouse to the right and you see this delete basket right there, or icon, excuse me. Click on it to delete. Now the color came through. We just change a color to kind of olive-like. Let me go back in a little bit and I want to kind of use this, you see this plus sign, just drag around. So this is another part that we can enhance a garment, how a garment look. You see how the pleat appear better if we go up a little bit or go to the right. See right there, if you come down so dark, we barely can see a pleat. But if you just increase or decrease the value of the color of the shoe, now we get to see a pleats better. It's all about realistic look, realistic feel. So in this case, right now, it looks much better already. So I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, let me zoom in a little more. Wow, a pleat looks amazing, guys. Another point that I want to point out here. See up here, if you click on this icon right here to turn it off, a pleat look really flat. That's what we don't want. We want to turn that on. Now a pleat looks really have this depth. As you can see right there, it's a huge difference. Okay. Next, I'm going to add the thickness onto this fabric, okay? I'm going to just click one on the page to deselect it. Now I'm going to just my key selects all the pattern pieces. Then you see right here under this property editor, come down to add thickness rendering. I'm going to change it. I try 1.5 is a perfect number for me, but you can just do 1, that would be fine too. Press down return enter on the keyboard to confirm. So it gave a pleat a more a little like crisp and sharpie looking. I'm going to press on the spacebar to simulate once again. And I'm going to press on the spacebar to stop the simulation. I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. So as you can see, now a pleat looks much better. However, there is something that we can improve on. Okay, so as you can see here, let me come to the top piece right here so we can see the effects, okay? You see right here, kind of push out. It's not even because some part of the sewing are turned, some are not. Next, I'm going to switch all the sewing to turn. So let me go in and I'm going to use the edit sewing tool over here, click on it to select. Then I'm going to zoom in right here. And I'm going to just my key select right there, okay? And if you look over here to this property editor and under sewing line type, our sewing type is custom angle rather than turn. We want to switch that to turn. To do so, I'm going to come over here to the twirling arrow, click on it, then select turn. Okay? Then press down the spacebar to simulate. Next, I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And pan this 2D window to the right, I'm going to strengthen these pattern pieces. Then I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to simulate. And press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to unstrengthen. And as you can see, now a pattern piece looks much better already. Again, go to this edit sewing tool, click on it, and then my key select just start sewing, and then change it to turn. Let me double check this one. Somehow it doesn't do it. Yeah, it is turn. Perfect. I'm going to do the same right here. Switch to turn. Then come over here. Change it to turn. So now I'm going to press down the spacebar once again to simulate. Okay. And I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to switch to transform pattern tool so we can see better. Then unfreeze this pattern piece. Click on it and then my key select just press on shift and click on all the pattern pieces that we want to unfreeze, and then right click and select unfreeze. Next, I'm going to show you when we darken the top piece of pattern will make this pleated pattern a little more pop. To do that, I'm going to come over here, click on that fabric to select, then I'm going to click on this copy command to copy the fabric, and I'm going to just name it small. Then I'm going to be sure to not press down the spacebar, guys, or your pleat will fall onto the floor. So I'm going to press down shift and then click, click, and click. I'm going to apply that fabric, the new one, onto the pattern pieces. Then I'm going to click on that fabric. You see right here under this object browser, and come down to color and click on it. Then I want to kind of bring the color down just a little bit. Just a slight shade, a little bit darker shade, make your pleat look much poppier. So I'm going to click on OK to confirm. So let me zoom in into this 2D window too, so we can compare. Right here, this odd segment that we create, so 3x3, and we create this 1.5 pleat. And right here, we create 6 segments, and here came out 3 pleats perfectly. And right here, we create 7 segments, and it came out 3.5 pleats. And right here, we create 3 pleats from the Pleats tool. Right here, we created from the Pleats Fold tool. So Pleats Fold tool with the Pleats Sewing tool, Pleats Fold tool with the Pleats Sewing tool for these 3 pleats piece that we create. And we did change all the particle distance to 5, and this pattern thickness rendering, we changed it to 1.5 to produce this amazing pleat looking thing. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, Designistas. If you find this video useful, remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Love it. Thanks, guys.